Welcome, my dear students. The ailing planet, the green movement's role. This chapter we are going to start now. This chapter is actually based on an article written by Nani Palkiwala, and it was published in Indian Express, dated 24 November 1994. So I'm going to explain it line by line. The hard words are gripped and green movement, and its meaning is given below. The chapter, The Ailing Planet, The Green Movement's Role, was an article published in the newspaper, The Indian Express, on November 24, 1994, written by Nani Palkiwala. He wrote about the declining health condition of Earth. The Green Movement was started nearly 25 years ago. From 1994, spread so quickly in the world history. The world's first nationwide Green Party was founded in New Zealand in 1972, and since then it has never looked back. Means the people are working continuously. Next paragraph. The hard words are irrevocably, holistic and ecological view, revolutionary, metabolic needs, and the explanation is now here. From some time, our views have shifted from seeing Earth and its resources as irreversible to complete opposite. We now understand that our resources need to converse for future generations. Copernicus taught mankind how the Earth and other planets revolve around the Sun, and it was a complete change which evolved human perception. Now, the Earth is seen as a living organism of which we are an integral part. Earth has its own metabolism and vital needs which humans should respect and preserve. Next paragraph. Hard words. Ethical obligation, stewards, sustainable development. And now explanation. Earth is now like a patient whose health is declining. We, as human beings, are now realizing our duty to be good managers of the planet and to be a responsible trustees to conserve the environment so that we can pass a legacy to the future generations. Sustainable development was popularized in the year 1987 by the World Commission on Environment and Development. In the reports, sustainable development is termed as a type of a development that meets the needs of the present generation without using, wasting, or compromising with natural resources so that future generations can meet their needs. Next paragraph. Hard words. Drawn, cataloged, reckon, languish, ignominious darkness. Now explanation. In a cage in a zoo, in Lusaka, Zambia, there reads a notice: the world's most dangerous animal. And inside the cage is a mirror that depicted that humans are the world's most dangerous animals. With the efforts of new agencies in the world, now humans are seen as the most dangerous animals. They have realized the importance of shifting to a new system based on partnership. Humans share the earth with about 1.4 million living species according to the classification of scientists. Biologists calculate that there are still millions of other species which are yet not classified due to their weakness or due to lack of knowledge about them. Next paragraph, hard words. Inter alia, is caused, impoverished, ailing. Now explanation. Brandt Commission was one of the early international commissions who dealt with the question of ecology and environment. They commissioned Mr. L. K. Jha as one of their commission members, who was an Indian citizen. Its first report raised a question that, are we going to leave a burned planet with aridid deserts, poor landscapes, and a poor environment for our future generations? Next paragraph, hard words. Synthetics, impaired, barren wastelands, deteriorate, decimated, and procure. And now explanation. There are four principal biological systems that form the foundation of the global economic system, according to the book by Leslie R. Brown, The Global Economic Prospect: Fisheries, Grasslands, Forests, and Croplands. These four systems provide food and raw material for industry, except for minerals and synthetics. These systems have reached an unsustainable point where their productivity has impaired. With this, fisheries will collapse, the forest will slowly disappear, grasslands will turn into barren wastelands, and croplands will become worse. Overfishing is very common nowadays, where people are becoming protein conscious. In poor countries, forests are being cut down on a large scale to obtain wood for cooking. In some areas, firewood is more costly than food. Many species are under destruction in tropical forests. So thank you for watching. This was explanation part 1, and I'll continue the explanation in part 2. Thank you very much.